So hi and welcome to today's video. So today I wanted to talk about actually one of my favourite car care products, and that is Garage Therapy Decontamination Shampoo. So I did a review of this product back in September, having used it a few times before, but since sort of filming that video I've discovered a few different uses of the product and really kind of discovered that it's more than just a shampoo you would use at the start of the decontamination process, but you can use it as sort of a tool really for plenty of different situations. So what I wanted to do in this video was discuss 8 different uses to maybe give you a bit of inspiration and give you a few ideas if you already have the product, and if you don't already have the product, maybe sort of open your eyes to some of the potential uses that it has, because I think it's definitely a product that's well worth looking into. So starting with the first use, and that is during the contact wash at the start of the decon process. So for this, Garage Therapy recommend 50ml of product in around a 20L bucket. I go a little bit less than this, to be honest, and find that 30ml is more than adequate, but it really is going to depend on how dirty the car is and also if there's any paint protection left on the car. So what are the advantages of using it as a contact wash at the start of the decon process? Well, firstly, it actually really does leave the paintwork a lot smoother. That's definitely something I've noticed in comparison to using other shampoos at the start of the process. So it does have those decontamination effects, being a decon shampoo itself. So that actually means that your clay bar doesn't need to work quite as hard, which has 2 main advantages. One, that it maintains the clay bar, and 2, that actually you're not dragging as many contaminants over the surface, which is going to help reduce the risk of marring that's going to occur during the process. And what's also kind of cool about this is that it really does kickstart the process. It's more efficient in a way than using a pH neutral shampoo that doesn't really add to the later decontamination steps that you have. But using this at the start of the wash process means that you're already starting it, and it does help to make everything a little bit more efficient. So the second use of Garage Therapy Decontamination Shampoo is that it does help to remove last stage protection products. So it won't strip really fresh protection, and it won't strip ceramic coatings unless they are sort of really on the last legs, and it might take a few hits for it to completely strip the protection, but it is very capable of sort of killing all the wax and sealants. They might show a little bit of water behaviour, but you maybe want to remove them if you're going to apply new protection, or maybe if you're going to correct the car and you just want to kind of remove it a little bit faster than it's doing itself. So for this, my favourite way to do it is to apply it in a foam lance, so by adding 400ml of water and 50ml of product, applying that to the entire car, leaving it to dwell for a couple of minutes, and then going over it with the wash mitt to provide a little bit of agitation and just really help the decon shampoo lift as much protection as possible. Give it a rinse and see where you're up to. It might take another hit, but you might actually find that that's enough to remove any protection before moving on to maybe correcting the car or applying something new. So the third use on this list is to deep clean the glass on the car. Now, so this is something that I found really helpful when I wanted to apply a coating to my car's glass. So it does help to remove some old sealants, but again, it does have all these decontamination properties in terms of leaving the surface smoother, helping to lift some of the contaminants already on there. And they again find it helpful to help sort of kickstart the decontamination process. There is other steps that I use, and I actually use this product recently in a video where I applied the Pyramid Car Care glass coat into my car. So I'll leave a link in the description to the full process, because I don't think you can completely decontaminate the glass using this product. I find that a water spot remover is helpful as well, but I do find it a useful product to begin the process with. So the next use that I have on this list is as a snow foam. What's really good about this as a snow foam is that it foams up very nicely despite being marketed as a shampoo. So you can use it as a pre-wash by adding 400ml of water and 50ml of product. Now, I'd personally only use it on a car that I was going to apply some fresh protection to, but I do find it helpful on cars that are really, really filthy, and standard kind of pre-wash products, whether you're using a citrus pre-wash or maybe an alkaline snow foam that's not particularly strong, then this can have some more of an effect to remove stubborn traffic film. So it is a little bit stronger than things like, you know, the Bilt-Hamber Auto Foam or Touchless or Wax Planet 8 Below. I'd use those in more of a maintenance wash, but on a car that I was going to either correct or protect later on, this can be helpful if it hasn't been given much attention in recent months and it has acquired a lot of dirt. So following on from this, another use is just as a contact wash for really, really filthy cars. There's a few reasons why you would use this. One, because it has really, really good cleaning ability, much better than a standard pH neutral car shampoo. So that's going to really help to remove some of that stubborn dirt that's on there. Again, it helps to decontaminate the car. So I really like to use it whenever I'm sort of cleaning my family's cars, and they ask me to do it every sort of maybe 6 months. So the cars do get quite dirty in that time, and I find that this really helps to sort of cut through that dirt. It helps to decontaminate the paint when I don't want to do a full decontamination on those cars because I don't have as much time and the owner wouldn't really notice it. I find that this is really useful because it does offer some of that decontamination process while still being quite a quick process because you're just using it in your normal contact wash. And also another advantage is that it's very, very lubricated, which does make it really a bit safer on dirty cars when you might not have been able to remove as much dirt as you wanted to during the pre-wash. There's going to be more dirt on that car, so having something that is more lubricated will help to reduce the risk of scratches and swirl marks, which again is really, really helpful. So another use I've got on this list, and this is one I discovered more recently, is as a tyre cleaner. Now, I use this as recommended by Garage Therapy before applying their tyre serum, which I do have a review on if you want to check that out. I'll leave a link in the description. So what I did was dilute this product 1 in 10 in a spray bottle, sprayed it all over the tyre, and then worked it in using a brush. It actually got the tyre so much cleaner than normal. So another use of Garage Therapy Decon Shampoo is during the claying process. So the best thing about this is how much lubrication the decontamination shampoo offers. So it does make it quite a safe clay bar lubricant. Of course, you can use other shampoos, but I find that this offers a really excellent level of lubrication just to help reduce the risk of marring during the process. Another thing is that it's really quite economical because you can use the solution that you have left from the wash process. So you don't have to go and get a new clay bar lubricant. You can just use what's already remaining. And also it does help with the rest of the decon process by helping to strip old waxes and sealants and providing a deeper clean than a standard car shampoo. And then the final use that I've got on this list is to freshen up ceramic coatings to kind of unclog them. And Garage Therapy recommend you could do this every sort of quarter or twice per year, depending on the sort of state that the ceramic coating is in. Now, this isn't something that I've actually tried personally, but Alan from DQ Details has a really, really good video demonstrating this. So I'm gonna leave a link in the description to that so you can check that out. But I have noticed myself that when I've applied it to a car where the protection looks like it's pretty much dead, there's not a lot of water behaviour remaining, when I've applied this, it's actually livened it up a bit and freshened it up a bit. So it's having a sort of similar kind of effect there. So I thought it was well worth mentioning if you do have a ceramic coated car, or maybe have a sealant that you expected a little bit more life out of, try using this and see whether it revives it, because it might just do that. So I hope you have enjoyed this video. Like I said, I'll leave a link to those videos I mentioned in the description below so you can check them out. If you don't already own this product and you're sort of on the fence, I think it's well worth looking into getting it and just trying it out because, as I've said, there's so many different uses for it. It's not just a shampoo, so I think it's well worth having just on the shelf to get out for these different kind of situations. So if you have enjoyed this video, it'd be brilliant if you could give it a like. Comment down below if you've got any questions. And if you're not subscribed already, you can subscribe for weekly detailing videos, making stuff like this all the time with different vehicle transformations and product reviews. So thank you very much again for watching, and I'll see you next time.